And I'm Scott Johnson in for Jack Pattie. We welcome Dr. Kevin Kavanagh of HealthWatch USA. Good morning, Doc.
Good morning, Scott.
Glad to have you with us. As always, let's start by talking about a topic that has come up a lot, especially after the vaccines were developed, and that's vaccine immunity versus natural immunity when we're talking about COVID-19.
Well, I think there's mounting evidence, both clinically and also in the laboratory, that natural immunity is not as good as the immunity from the vaccines. Department of Public Health from Kentucky, they released a report, and this was along with the CDC, that found that if you had natural immunity, you're 2.3 times as likely to get a reinfection as getting a breakthrough infection with the vaccine. And if you think about this, it really does kind of make sense, because natural immunity, you don't have any sort of control over the dosage of the virus that you're given. And as you know, the severity of disease is related to the viral dosage. So it may just be a mild disease and you don't get much immunity. And of course, if you get severe disease and long hauler syndrome, you may have better immunity, but who wants to do that? Vaccines, on the other hand, are very safe. You can get them again. And also, when you get them again, you're not going through the dangers of having COVID. So vaccines really have a lot of advantages, both in their safety and the fact you've got the dosage that is controlled. Now, the mRNA vaccines, those are really, I consider almost medical miracles, because you're just given the spike protein, and that is what your body reacts to. So you're not reacting to all sorts of other parts of the virus that will not kill the virus. You're just reacting to the part of the spike protein that your body needs to react to in order to neutralize that virus. So for me, I think vaccines are something that are really wonderful, and I do encourage everybody to go out and get them, especially with this Delta variant.
We're going to need boosters?
I believe so. The data that I'm seeing out of Israel and also out of the United Kingdom indicates that over the ensuing months, let's say 5 months or greater, and if you're elderly, your immunity may be waning and that boosters would be required. In that group of people, they're starting to see not only more hospitalizations, but there have even been a few deaths. So yes, boosters are important. Now, I need to tell everybody, myself, I wouldn't run out right now and try to get a booster or a third shot, because it's been said a number of times by Dr. Fauci and other experts that we may be having some immunoescape variants that are on the horizon that'll evade last year's vaccine, because that's really what we're dealing with. So I believe that they're trying to formulate a booster that will actually cover some of these new variants. So in other words, you're going to want a booster that not only boosts for last year's virus, but also for this year's virus and the variants that they're worried about. That would be the most ideal booster, and I'm hoping that's the reason why they're holding off instead of rushing to get everybody a shot again, similar to what Israel's doing and the United Kingdom's planning. And of course, if you get a shot today and then they come out with a upgraded, redone booster in a month, it's going to be hard to get two shots within a month and get yourself augmented again. I think you may be, well, you may have a lot of side effects with that. So I would hold off and follow the advice of your doctor and public health officials.
Whenever we talk about vaccines, somebody comes up and says, but what about all the deaths from vaccines? Can you address that?
I haven't seen any. I've seen a lot of deaths, and unfortunately, who have died from COVID-19. I don't know anybody who's died from the vaccine. I mean, this is how bad it is. People call up and say, oh, long hauler syndrome's not a factor. I know a lot of people that have long hauler syndrome. Chronic shortness of breath, chronic coughs, heart arrhythmias. One has their hair falling out. I mean, it's unbelievable. So again, even if you have mild or moderate COVID, you want to avoid that. It's not entirely safe. So again, get vaccinated. It's going to cut down on your chances of getting mild disease and moderate disease, and it's very good at cutting down your chances of being in the hospital and also of dying. And believe me, those latter two are big pluses.
I didn't have a chance to ask you this before we went on, so forgive me if I'm blindsiding you with this one. I saw a report of research out of Case Western Reserve talking about myocarditis and pericarditis, heart inflammation, in teenagers, because there has been some concern that there were a few cases of that when teens started getting the vaccination. Now, what Case Western Reserve said is that the chance of it is six times higher if you get COVID than it is if you get the vaccine.
Oh, yes. Well, definitely. We talked about that last year. Everybody thought I was crazy of the young athletes, especially if they were male athletes that were coming down with myocarditis. Yeah, this virus is as much a cardiac as a lung virus. And what scares me is that all these asymptomatic people, they may really have a pretty good infection. They just don't have symptoms, because when the virus affects the heart and the vasculature, and that's its primary mode of attack, you may not have many symptoms. Myocarditis isn't always symptomatic, but you may develop then problems many years or even decades down the line, for example, of a cardiac myopathy. Idiopathic cardiac myopathy, which is a leading cause that leads to heart transplants, idiopathic cardiac myopathy is felt to be caused by a silent viral infection. And a lot of the doctors are scared that this may be what's happening with COVID. So yes, there are so many reasons why we need to protect our young children, and also why if you're asymptomatic, it doesn't mean you're out of the woods. You want to avoid this infection. So even if you're vaccinated, you should be wearing a mask, because with these vaccines, it'll protect you fairly well from hospitalizations and deaths. But as far as getting mild or moderate illness, it will not. I know several people personally that are fully vaccinated that have gotten a good case, what I would consider a good case of COVID-19. They are at home. They're not in the hospital. And so that is a huge plus. But nevertheless, the vaccines are not 100% protective with the Delta variant. They were very, very good, outstandingly good with last year's virus. But as you know, people didn't want to get vaccinated. They didn't want to abide public strategies. We spread the virus around. And lo and behold, we now have a variant that's more difficult to deal with. So we need to do both. We need to get vaccinated. We need to wear masks. And above all, we need to open our schools safely, because with this virus, the children are out of the woods. They need to be protected.
All right. One more thing before I let you go. You sent me a link about a story about COVID-19 in white-tailed deer. And to be dead honest, why should I care?
Well, this is a big problem. Well, first of all, if you're a hunter, you may care that you don't get COVID from the deer that you shot and had to drag out of the woods. But one of the things that we're worried about is that this virus sets itself up in an animal host, and then it has a separate track of mutation and will then reinfect mankind periodically for years to come. And this possibly is a way for it to do it. Now, it's not known if that virus will be cleared by the deer, but they took 385 antibody tests in four different states, and 40% of those were positive for SARS-CoV-2. And that is not good. And they also have a number of other papers and studies that they relied on, where they documented asymptomatic carriage, prolonged viral shedding, virus in the feces and nasal secretions, and spread between the deer. So, yes, this is very problematic. We do not want to have this virus to set up an animal host, because then you're not talking about, you know, decontaminating or getting the virus out of the human community. Now you're talking about removing it from the whole biosphere, and that's much harder to accomplish. So I think that is problematic. It's something we do need to follow. And of course, worst case scenario for the deer hunters, and believe me, this is just worst case scenario, similar to the minks in the Netherlands, they might have to even call some of the deer population. So it can be very problematic. With cattle, it can get in cattle, but they're vaccinating cattle. that's more of a captive population. The deer, as you know, run all around at our house down in Somerset. They're over the porch and all over the place. So that can be problematic, and it's something we need to follow very carefully.
Dr. Kevin Kavanagh, HealthWatchUSA.org, thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you very much, Scott. I appreciate it.